You see, Judge Hlophe, he has already started the man. He's interviewing this judge, this aspiring judge, advocate. He's saying to the man, you were given a chance to practice as a judge. Now you have to be appointed. He counts years and he said, in this space of time, you only delivered one judgment. And it's like, if we were to give you a chance to practice as an advocate, you are gonna become worse. And I would like us to talk about this thing said by Judge Hlophe. You will realize that it interlinks with what Judge Maumela is suspended for, and now there are chances of him being impeached. He had to say he's sick to stop the whole process. So I'm going to play you that video, Judge Hlophe. Don't worry. I'm going to play you that video, Judge Hlophe. But in the Senzo Mahiwa case, there was a judge called Judge Maumela. Number one, he appointed himself in that case. That is a statement coming from Judge President Gauteng, in the Gauteng Division, Mlambo. He appointed himself in that one. Number two, he had a tendency of not giving judgment. In fact, it has been said that till today, there's a case he presided over in 2017 or 14. He only released the judgment maybe a year ago when the person, the complainant in the case, had even died. He had delayed judgments for no apparent reason. So I'm talking about the quality of judicial. Remember the DA and those ones who are claiming to be fighting and trying to preserve the constitution. Remember their claim is that the quality of this man is questionable. Whatever advice he's giving is questionable. But now I'm listening to the man giving advice now. I'm like, but before I proceed, wait. There's an advice that I want to give you, and it is this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay, so I'm going to play you the video, Judge Hlophe, doing the interview. What an interview. So remember that those ones who are about freedom under law, who have never held anybody that is in support of ETA accountable, it's always them fighting other people, which I have a problem with it, because they're always disguising themselves as people who are fighting for the law. We are defending the constitution. You know what I'm saying? They always portray themselves as people who are defending the constitution. So it is very surprising when you see them not pitching up or not defending the constitution against people against people who are affiliated with ETA. So they've said nothing about, them, but they said everything about Judge Hlophe. He's incompetent. He cannot do this. He cannot do that. He cannot do this. He cannot do that. That is exactly what they were telling us without us asking them. Judge Hlophe in action. Take a look at what the man has done here.
This commission is with you. You would like us to recommend you for appointment, notwithstanding that you have acted for 6 terms, and you only have 1 reported judgment, and other candidates have far more than that. Yes. Secondly, notwithstanding that we have not finalized a single criminal trial, And thirdly, notwithstanding the obvious delays which have been highlighted in terms of you handing down your judgments, notwithstanding your experience as an advocate for 25 years, you still delay in handing down the judgments. And I can tell you from my experience as a judge president, candidates who delay in handing down judgments when they are still acting only become worse after the permanent appointment. So if it takes you 6 months to produce a judgment, the moment you are appointed, it will take you 6 years. So notwithstanding all of that, we must recommend you for appointment.
Yes, Chope, I've explained the matters that was highlighted.
Thank you. No further questions.
Yes, carry on, Ms. Stewart. Or have you finished, Ms. Stewart?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Listening to Judge Hlophe on the video that I've just shared with you, do you think is as compromised as they are making it to be? Because they've always told us that he is compromised, right? For me, you know, I like the fact that the man, the questions that Judge Hlophe asked an expiring judge, to say, listen, I've been a president, judge president in the Western Cape. I served there and I've seen that hiring people who does not deliver judgment on time, they become worse when they are given the opportunity, now they are judges. You know, it reminds me of an advice. I'll tell you what, I know the advice is not necessarily the same as the one of judicial, but there's an advice that at church we are always told. We are always told that, hey guys, choose wisely, because if your partner has got these tendencies before marriage, think not that just by the virtue of marrying them, the problems and the things that you have seen before will suddenly disappear. Instead, whatever you have seen before marriage, it multiply whilst they are in marriage. The principle there, or the fundamental thing between the two set by Judge Hlophe and what I'm just telling you now, is that when people get what they want, being in this case, you want to be a judge, you become the corrupt one. You are easily corruptible because you yourself don't deliver judgment on time. And that is a cause for concern. In the case of Judge Maumela, for instance, He was not alone, but he has been accused of the same thing as well, that you delay judgments. And what is the point of seeking justice on a case that you know exactly you're not gonna win that case? What is the prospect of trusting a judicial when judges in the very same judicial do not deliver judgments on time? What is the purpose of actually judgment to begin with? So I applaud the work of Judge Hlophe. Under the criticism and the severity of his criticism, he's still performing very well. You know what I'm saying? I mean, come on, what type of majority is this one where a man performs extremely good and they've chosen? I haven't even listened to the side of Malema because he is very good. That guy is very good in drilling people. Oh. Hey, Malema is very good in drilling people. Oh, Malema is going to drill you. Oh, Malema is going to scrutinize you. That guy is going to take you from pillar to post, but in the right way. He's going to, that guy is going to question you. I've not even listened to a conversation where Malema was dealing with the man. But we'll do that. Shortly, probably, I don't know.